Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. Today, we continue our exploration of the recent update shared by the team behind the groundbreaking scientific experiment, the SAFIRE Project. As described in our recent interviews with physicist Wal Thornhill, the SAFIRE Project is an independent audit of the electric sun model, first proposed by engineer Ralph Juergens in the 1970s. As Thornhill noted, Thunderbolt's colleague Dr. Donald Scott also extended Juergens' electric sun model through his recognition of what is called the PNP transistor action of anode tufts, or photospheric granulations on the sun, which were successfully reproduced in SAFIRE's Phase 1 proof of concept. In this episode, Dr. Scott shares his thoughts on SAFIRE's most exciting results to date, including the evidence it has produced of low-energy nuclear transmutations.
For over 100 years now, since Eddington first dictated that he knew the answer, how did the sun make all its power and all that energy, where does it come from? It came from the fusion of hydrogen into helium. And everybody immediately sucked that up because Einstein was in his glory at that time, and the atomic nuclear chemistry was in the news. And so, yes, we got it. That's the way it is. The stars make their energy from hydrogen to helium fusion. And then some 100 years went by, and nobody questioned that, until finally, I guess, you know, we also realized that there has been 200 years of people looking at the sun through spectroscopes. And we've managed to discover about 68 of the known chemicals, that is to say elements, on the sun, in the sun's atmosphere. They're there. They're in the sun. Where did they come from? If the sun gets its energy from this hydrogen and helium fusion, okay, I see where the hydrogen and helium came from, but where did the calcium and the manganese and the titanium and all the rest of it come from? And the standard answer is, oh, it was made by explosions in novae stars way out in somewhere in our galaxy or even in other galaxies. And then those explosions blew it all over the place like fairy dust. Fairy dust spreading through the cosmos. And then it settled on our star. But that has nothing to do with our star. Our star is only hydrogen and helium. What Monty did was not to falsify, I mean, I say Monty, but of course it's everybody on the team, but to simply give a real, we have done it here in our lab, not explanation, but example that, yes, you can form these other elements in a very, well, let's say, non-hydrogen bomb kind of way. That is to say, you do it in the laboratory yes, it requires something as magnificent as SAFIRE, but the only reason we need SAFIRE is because we can't duplicate the sun in our own laboratories here on Earth. We'd burn the place up. So what we're trying to do is to model the sun. We're trying to come up with an example here in our lab of how the sun works. And he's done a very good job. And he's produced exactly what we see in the sun. It is obvious now that those other elements are indeed made right in our sun, and very probably in all other stars, at least most other stars. And it is done not in the core of the sun, but on the surface. If you look at Monty's film, those other elements appear on the surface of the anode. And it's done electrically through electric plasma. And I just think it's almost obvious. We don't need any more fairy tales about explosions of novae in Alpha Centauri. I did predict that back when I first wrote my book in 2006. I said that whatever nuclear fusion is taking place on the sun is likely occurring in the double layer above the photosphere, not deep within the sun's core. And the products of this fusion process are the metals that give rise to the absorption lines in the sun's spectrum. And I think Monty's work has certainly shown that is very likely the answer, and that's what's happening. The point is that it really isn't that important. It's not our purpose to disprove or falsify their answers, but SAFIRE has offered a very good reason why there are the other types of elements and even some molecules formed that are not from these novae explosions a gazillion light years away. A couple of observations I made when I looked at that film. You will notice there that Monty was very excited by, and I can see why, I'm excited by it too. He found in the very powerful scanning electron microscope photos a sphere. And he found that the highest magnification he was able to get to when they were looking, and they found all these other calcium and sodium and all the rest of it in there that had not started there, but was formed there. Right down in the middle of this was a little sphere. And I'm not sure if they figured out what that sphere was yet. But the first thing that occurred to me was, a sphere. Well, have we in the electric universe ever come upon anything like that? Well, what about C.J. Ransom and Wall's blueberries that they formed in C.J.'s lab? And we saw those, they're called the Martian blueberries for the reason that they were first discovered on the surface of the planet Mars. And as Monty pointed out, nobody knew or could figure out why these things were in such nice little spheres. So there they are. They found, we could be, at least I think they should further investigate, is that the genesis of these Martian blueberries in a process very much like this. The other thing that I did notice is if you look very carefully at the image that Monty presents there in that video, at those little spheres, you will see that the equator, if you will, is slightly raised. And it looked like the last space news with, who was it, Wall, talking about Bennu and the other one. And they have this strange shape, and there is this raised equator. Well, if you look very carefully at that little sphere that Monty found with his scanning microscope, that too has a raised equator. And so we're seeing, when things begin to jibe like that, it begins to make you think, gee, maybe we should see and think about why they're the same. What's going on here? That's all I really have to say about the video, except to say that I think it's magnificent. I think the future does maybe hold jobs for the SAFIRE-like reactor for the remediation of nuclear radiation from decaying atomic fuel. You know, so you don't have to bury it in there in Nevada someplace, but can we decontaminate the area by somehow treating it? It's all in the future, and it's all possible, and it's all wonderful. But the point is, I think that we really should celebrate and be happy about is that SAFIRE has definitely shown that we don't need these explosions on these far, far distant stars to explain how the fairy dust got spread through the cosmos. It's formed right there on the surface of our sun.